The successful accomplishment of the launch of PSLV C60 for the SpaceX mission. The rocket has placed the satellites in the right orbit, which is 475 kilometer circular orbit. That's only one part of the mission, injection of the SpaceX satellites. Now, in another 15 minutes, the fourth stage of PSLV will change its orbit from 475 kilometer to 350 kilometer lower orbit by first phase of firing, and also the second phase of firing will be at about 1 hour 20 minutes later after the liftoff. So that process is continuing to enable POEM operations to happen. Further to that, the spacecraft is also going to wait for the solar panel deployment. So the team spacecraft is looking at whether the panels are deployed or not, so we'll get a confirmation soon. So as far as we are concerned, the mission is very well as far as the rocket is concerned. So it has placed the satellite in the right orbit. The SpaceX two satellites are moved. You would have seen in the animation that they moved little one behind the other. So over the period of time, further days, it will pick up further distance, travel to almost a 20 kilometer distance away. And then the rendezvous and docking process will start. And we hope that the docking process can happen in another 1 week. The nominal time is going to be approximately 7th of January. So I'm waiting for the panel deployment status. I think you have the status.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So I would like to say that the panels of the satellites have been deployed successfully. So congratulations to the entire team of the PSLV project who put the satellite in the right orbit. Also the SpaceX team who worked a very innovative, novel, cost-effective docking demonstration mission using two small satellite bus architecture. So congratulations to them as well. And also two very important parties of this mission is the POEM-4, where we have 24 payloads hosted, which are from startups, industries, academic institutions, research laboratories, and also from ISRO centers. All the R&D payloads are there waiting for testing in the coming days, in fact in months. So congratulations to them for successful accomplishment of all the mission objectives through the POEM. So once again, thank you. Before I hand over, I would like to request the mission director, Mr. Jayakumar, to speak a few words.
Thank you, sir. So, hearty congrats to Team ISRO for venturing into the exciting domain of space docking. This mission is once again a POEM intensive mission. We have 24 payloads on board, and congratulations to the team who have developed these payloads adhering to our schedules. And congratulations to InSpace for facilitating the delivery of these payloads. This time we are flying the indigenous Vikram 3201 based mission management computer in POEM. Also we have interesting experiments like space robots doing debris capture and inchworm walking, then plasma smeric and electron density measurements. Three biological experiments are there, advanced inertial sensors, green propulsion systems, etc. And this month, in fact, we had two launches of PSLV from the same launch pad, that is the first launch pad. So after the first launch, the SDC team, SHAR team, was very quick in refurbishing the launch pad, special thanks to them, and also to the teams in VSSE. We also had the movement of the fully integrated vehicle that is up to the PS4 stage from PIF to MST. So let me thank the SDC and VSSE teams for making this possible. On this occasion, let me thank Chairman ISRO, who is a role model for all of us, and all the center directors for the ardent support provided, and to the mission executives, Sri Damodaran, Chandramouli, Grahadure, Raghavendra, and Surendran, who have worked as a coherent team. I thank all the SDS and SR agencies spread across different centers for their tremendous efforts to make this launch on schedule. Let me take this opportunity to thank Chairman and members of LAB, MRR, FRR, ORC, and all the DRTs for the extensive reviews and clearing all systems. I place on record our deep appreciation for our industry partners for the key role they play in realizing different systems and carrying out the integration of the vehicle as per schedule. Let me also thank my own PSLV project team for their tireless efforts put in for the past few months. Thanks to the admin and auxiliary staff who have supported our campaign activities. Finally, I thank our dear family members for understanding us and providing wholehearted support for keeping our mission successful. Wishing all of you a happy new year 2025. Jai Hind.
the concept of the docking experiment in orbit has been a long journey in terms of conceptualization, the architecture of these two satellites that came about, and building it over many years of work done by the team at URSC, UR Rao Satellite Center. The current satellite project director will speak to you now.
Respected Chairman ISRO and our various center directors and distinguished members of our ISRO community who have all assembled here, and my dear colleagues, good evening to all of you. At the outset, I would like to congratulate our PSLV team for the two successful launches that in a month, I think it's a record, and for proving that way the vehicle's robustness once again. You have also placed our twin babies in a perfect circular orbit as per our requirement, and I'm happy to share the news that our solar panels are successfully deployed and the strikes out are on their journey, unfolding their wings towards the docking experiment, docking experiment, which is expected to be happening around January 1st week. This mission is very interesting and challenging, not just because of our space docking experiment, the interesting POEM-4 payloads, which are also unique and futuristic in nature. Let me congratulate all the our POEM team members, payload team, for their further operation success. On this happy occasion, I would like to crossing this important milestone of our SpaceX project, I thank our Chairman ISRO and Director URSC for their valuable guidance and support provided during the entire period. Also, I would like to put on record my gratitude and appreciation to all our earlier program directors, project directors, and project executives for their significant contribution. Also, SpaceX has undergone a thorough review mechanisms. Various review mechanism. I would like to put on record by sincere appreciation and gratitude to all our committee members, chairmen, for their invaluable effort, guidance, and contributions. As you are aware, the space sector is going through a phase change to enable the private participation in a big way to meet our growing demands. As per our latest policy, space policy guidelines, as an enabler, SpaceX was assembled, integrated, and tested at an vendor premises for the first time. As earlier, many other industries also have significantly contributed for the fabrication and testing of the subsystem packages. I would like to take this opportunity to sincerely thank all the industrial partners for their valuable contributions in growing our space ecosystem. My appreciation to our admin, accounts, purchase, stores, transport, canteen, medical, and maintenance teams for their effort in ensuring all our team members are able to concentrate on their work peacefully. Last but not the least, I'd like to thank my entire project team for their sincere and untiring hard work, and their family members for their understanding, better understanding of the situation. I'm sure that with that kind of a support and effort put forth, we will be successful in meeting all the mission objectives of docking, undocking, power transfer, and payload operations. Let us pray and wish for the same. Best wishes to all of us, and happy advance new year. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Surendran, the satellite director. Now, what we are all anxiously going to wait is the operation of the SpaceX docking. I think the very innovative architecture of the docking mechanism and the further mission process have been fully validated using extensive testing and demonstration in the UR Rao Satellite Center. So before we go into that operations, there will be a few days of gap, and the operations will happen control center from ISTRAC Bangalore. But before that actual activity happened today, I would like to request the director of UR Rao Satellite Center to speak about what is going to be happening in the coming few days.
Good evening. Congratulations to everyone for this spectacular and perfect launch of the SpaceX 01 and 02 satellites into the circular 475-kilometer, 55-degree orbit as intended. As Chairman was mentioning, the activity for us starts now. The vehicle has given a small delta V by delaying the second satellite separation by about 3 seconds, and this will about 10 meters per second rate this distance will grow, and we are expecting by tomorrow evening the two satellites will get separated by about 20 kilometers. At this point we will start using the onboard propulsion system on one of the two satellites to arrest the drift, so that we maintain 20 kilometer distance between the two satellites, and like a twins they will be going around in the same orbit with the same speed. We have to wait for 4 days for the appropriate sun orientation for the docking to happen, because in this orbit the sun is going to go all around the spacecraft body, so we require another 4 days of wait for the sun relative position to come in a favorable condition, so that in the docking orientation the two spacecraft will generate sufficient power. At this point again we will initiate the drift of the two satellites, so that the 20 kilometer distance is progressively reduced to 5 kilometers, 1.5 kilometers, like that it will reduce, and after we reach 5 kilometer onwards we are going to enable the inter satellite RF link between these two satellites, so that the two satellites will talk to each other and exchange their own position, attitude, this kind of information they will exchange, which will enable us to evaluate the software logics which are there in the spacecraft, and also the several new sensors that have been developed by our laboratory for electro-optic systems, Bangalore. These sensors will be one by one evaluated for their fitness for initiating this docking sequence. So docking sequence will start once the inter-satellite distance is reduced to 1.5 kilometers. From there onwards, three different algorithms are going to be used, guidance algorithms are going to be used to minimize the propulsion propellant consumption, but achieve the required movement between the two satellite without actually deviating too much away, so that the sensors do not lose a line of sight among these two. This is a very innovative way this has been done. And once we reach 3 kilometers, three meters, the final guidance algorithm will be initiated, which will be a constant velocity PV guidance, it is called. With the constant velocity of about 10 millimeters per second, the chaser satellite will go and enter into the target satellite. This will be detected by another sensor on board the satellite, which will initiate the docking sequence inside the two satellite. So with the initiation of this sequence, the latches will be released and the clamps on both sides will try to grab each of the satellite, so that from both sides the satellite will try to hug each other, and once they hold each other together, the ring which has been extended on the chaser satellite will be retracted, so that the target satellite will be pulled towards the chaser satellite and the two satellites will become as a single unit, and here the rigidization will be carried out. That means that you require a minimum force of more than about 25 Newton to even give a small separation between these two satellites. So the two satellites will get rigidized, and then the initiation of the power transfer mechanism will be done, where we will transfer power from satellite 1 to satellite 2. This will be used to power a heater in the satellite 2, which will demonstrate to us that the power transfer has indeed taken place, and that will also be seen on that day of the docking itself. After this, the combined two satellite composite will be controlled by the control system of one of the satellite. This is also an important new requirement, enabling technology for future, where we go and dock it to the International Space Station, like that our Bharatiya Antariksh Station, or any other two satellite, when we are docking together, we should be able to control the entire composite with only one control system. That is going to be demonstrated. Then the two satellites will get separated and move away, so that the independent payload operations will happen. So this is the sequence of activities. We are hoping that we will achieve this docking by the 7th of January in forenoon. All systems working well and all our logics working as per our plan. This is the sequence of activities. The FedEx mission itself is a demonstration of the tenacity of our teams, because as Chairman mentioned, this work as a thought experiment started in around 1989, and at that time nobody thought that this is required for us, but the tenacity is seen, so that finally when the project was approved in 2016, we have realized this over several years, developed several test beds for validating the mechanism as well as the docking sequence, the sensors. Large amount of work has been done. It has been a combined effort of so many people across the ISRO centers as well as industry. And as project director already mentioned, this is also one of the trailblazers for our industry involvement in the satellite integration and testing. So far, large satellites have not been realized in the industry by themselves. This is the first time these two satellites have been integrated and tested in the industry, and we hope that this is going to be the first of several such satellites which will be done by the industry on their own. That is what we all wish. And once again, let me thank the PSLV team for providing a perfect launch, because a good start is half the work done. So that has happened now, the good start has come, and I'm sure our teams right now at Bangalore tracking the satellite and preparing for the next operations are going to be busy for the next few days. Thank you very much for your patience for hearing me the whole thing, and wish you all the very best for very, very happy new year, because this year started on a bang with the ExpoSat launch again by PSLV on January 1st, and we are ending this year almost on the last day of the year with another PSLV launch with the SpaceX, which is a technology mission. What else we can ask for when we are working in a technology organization? And this is our gift, New Year gift to the nation, Indian nation. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much. What I need to say that already has been told by Shankaran. I won't prolong. With me, my team, especially the directors of all centers are here. To save time, I am not requesting each one to speak, but their contribution in providing the systems for the rocket as well as the satellites is really important. Their leadership for building the very resilient, innovative team. And specifically today, I would like to thank each one of you for your contribution and work, and that is what is left behind for us to accomplish the docking mission as well. But very important point which I would like to speak and then conclude, we are waiting for the PS4 stage to change its orbit. It will be happening any moment. We are in the data non-availability zone. We will get soon the confirmation, and the whole night we will be watching that part, but we won't keep you waiting for it. We will get to know about it tomorrow morning. The orbit of the PS4 stage will change to 350 kilometers, where the POEM payloads will be initiated. Based on the ground commands, each of the payloads will be tested. There are very interesting payloads on board, which many of you would have already read from our websites about the robotic activities, as well as many of the interesting life science related payloads, as well as propulsion related payloads in the POEM. So we have the teams from many, many startups, industries, academic institutions enabled by InSpace to be brought to the POEM. There are 10 payloads from NGEs, and there are around 11 payloads from ISRO centers testing various technologies. And we wish that all of them go very well. And that is a work for us in the new year 2025 to see all of this happen, including the docking. So I will say goodbye to you at this moment from the control center at Satish Dhawan Space Center, and wish you a very, very happy new year 2025. In 2025, we will have many missions. To start with, we have the mission of GSLV launching the NVS-02 in the month of January. So when we until that we announce that mission, let me say good night and bye from Satish Dhawan Space Center, Sriharikota. Thank you.